fucking tornado alley. I told them this. When they built this godforsaken town, it was on a tornado path. But would they listen? Would they hell?
Hello and welcome to the latest streamer interview from BanterCrew.co.uk. Today we have my missus from MyMrs Gaming, who is joining us to answer our streaming questions, and so we can find out a little bit more about him and what he's all about. Hello, my missus.
Hello there, and hello everyone, and welcome to this interview that is being set up by the BanterCrew.co.uk to help profile streamers such as myself and other streamers. So hi, Wookie Moon.
Hello, and obviously you're a founding member of BanterCrew.co.uk. Did you want to tell us a little bit, just as an intro, how that got started?
Get him down. Yeah, well, BanterCrew.co.uk got started from just a few of us streaming A3L on a different community, and we was all quite active streaming and doing quite a lot of server events and doing activities for the people and the public to actually get involved in. And we sort of decided to grow that on a bit more of a bigger scale, rather than just doing A3L, but to do multiple games at once. And rather than stay being nuzzled in the community we was in, it was just primarily Arma Free Life, we decided to branch out and have a crack at setting up ourselves. And since we have started off, we've grown a few numbers, and we've helped each other out, and we're getting a bit further on with what we want to be doing.
Fantastic. And it is a great community, so if you'd like to join, details are in the show notes below. So we've got 16 questions for you, my missus, today. 16 questions that we'll be asking, hopefully, lots of YouTubers and Twitch streamers and Hitbox streamers alike. Are you ready?
I'm ready whenever you are. Fire away.
Okie dokie. So, what game started you streaming and gave you the bug to stream more?
Okay, so it was going right back to when I used to play World of Tanks, and I still play World of Tanks quite a bit, but it was more people on YouTube rather than live Twitch streaming that I watched. And it was more getting to when a new tank came out to find out the tank review and stuff and how it went in battles and stuff. And it sort of, that's what gave me the bit of a bug and stuff. And some of my very first videos I've actually done, they weren't actually streamed, they were recorded and then put onto YouTube. So it's me being a fool in something like TOG 2 or something, just doing outlandish things, having good battles with my mates. And that's what started giving me the bug, and I've not stopped since then.
Superb. Which do you, just as an extra question, which do you prefer? You know, do you prefer streaming just to Twitch and uploading, or do you upload to YouTube stuff singly?
I like to dual cast at the same time. I dual cast through Twitch and Hitbox. And I like to, if it's something worthwhile or something to feature, I like to put onto YouTube. I don't generally put everything I stream onto YouTube, because off of it could just be me babbling, you know, and it's, unless I'm doing something focused and worthwhile, I'll put it onto YouTube to come back to it at a later date.
Awesome. Okay, question number two. How much has game streaming changed from when you first started?
Well, like I said, it wasn't so much streaming at the time I started. It was more about recording on frags or something like that, and then uploading it onto YouTube and messing about. And I've never been a technical type of guy to actually put it into a video editor and give all the fancy overlays and the fancy writing on the top. I'm very much plug and play, you get what you see, outtakes and all. So, but that's what got me into it, you know. And it's changed so much now, because it's become so much of a global industry, so to speak. We've got some of these big monster streamers out there, like Lyric or Sat Syndicate or Frankie 1080 on the PC, you know, they're actually making a career out of it, and you know, they're actually being sponsored to play these games. So it has changed a lot, and I think if you hit the time right and you got successful, you do something right, you do have the option of taking it forward, I think.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Question three. What is your favourite food? I love food-related questions.
I love food-related questions. It's not bread. Just so you know. Yeah. No, I suppose my favourite food would be really good Mexican chili. I do quite like spicy food. I like nice, a proper Mexican chili. A few pinto beans in, but no kidney beans. You know, it's all good. It's like whoever decided to put them in. It's a British thing, isn't it? It's just not good. You know, they ruined it for me. Everywhere I go now, I go, oh, could just do with a chili. It's packed full of bloody kidney beans, so it ruins it. But yeah, chili's my favourite. I do like spicy food.
Lovely jubbly. Okay, what recording streaming software do you use? Also, do you edit your finished product?
So obviously, from my previous question, I do struggle doing the editing side of it. I'm very lucky I've got help from within our community to actually make me overlays and bits and bobs and stuff like that for me. But generally, I try and do all my recording through OBS, and I will do multiple takes sometimes to get exactly what I want, or just I'll try and cut out the half an hour sections out of videos that I want, where you get, you know, warts and all, basically. But that's how I do it. OBS, I use Twitch alerts and then notifications, and I do very little editing out of it. I just wang it up and there it goes.
Okay, thank you. Question number five. Can you name your all-time top three games of any platform?
Oh, that's a question. Well, it's got to be Doom for starters, because I wasted so much time on that. My wife came and told me she was pregnant with my first child. I'm like, oh great, but I'm playing Doom. that's a lifetime memory, that one. So I'd say Doom. Also, I very first started playing years and years back on some really old platforms and stuff, but I think the most enjoyable one I played was something like Eye of the Beholder or Dungeon Keeper or Dungeon Master on the Amiga 500. Some of these like games where you're just going down level through level. And I think Medal of Honor as well, from an all-time favourite first-person shooter. I played it very competitively back in the day and did quite well with a few clans and won quite a few tournaments, prizes and stuff. So yeah, they're my top three games.
Awesome. Medal of Honor is one of those really good games, especially if you get a good team with you as well, and you play that. You know, presumably that's what you do. You're like in a team competing, or were you single?
Yeah. It was all about being in clan wars, and we played in a realism mod, so overrunning and gunning
too late on the yield, so
a lot harder. All the guns were beefed up, one shot, one kill. Everyone wanted to use a scope to hit the shot kill, so it did change the gameplay massively from the arcade regular clan wars.
Okay. Question number six. You may inspire other people to start streaming from your videos. Is there someone who inspired yourself to start streaming? One blow into your legs
and then but I really do hope. I hope I inspire people to stream, because if I can do it being 42 this year and just some pleb from Yorkshire, I'm sure other people can do it as well. But the person who really got me into it, I suppose, would be the Mighty Jingles, you know, because I did actually follow him through to YouTube and then onto his live streams, and I thought, hey, I can never do it this, and he gave me the bug to do it, and it weren't until I came across other people through the community I was in Arma Free Life that I actually got to know how to do it and got everything set up and a minor understanding to it, and then I went out and I spent the time learning how to set everything up and get things working, and then I ended up being quite an expert in setting OBS up. So yeah, it's a strange world.
Yep. Okay, question number eight. Is there a game out in the future or even now that you're looking forward to stream? The blood,
though. The amount of blood. Out of all the games that I've got and there's games that I want in the future, but I think the game I'm most looking forward to actually stream, and it's been the most enjoyable one I've done, is actually Savage Lands. I'm looking forward to carrying on doing a little bit more with the Savage Lands and things like that, you know.
Yeah, Savage Lions is a great game. You got a series on Savage Lions on your YouTube channel, and we can see a little bit of that in the background just now.
Oh, lots of stags, yeah. Oh, lots of fucking wolves. Make sure you keep yourself healed, man. Get on the rock, they can't get you.
Yeah. You're inside the building.
On the rock. I can deal with
I'm running around, I'm trying to get inside the building.
I'm with your help now. Oh!
Sorry, come in.
Sorry, I don't need to, I can kill the motherfuckers.
Can you?
I'll do him. I'll come around in a minute. Stay inside, I'll get him.
Just gonna get some more bandages.
Question number 9. Do you have any pets?
Yes, I do have a pet. I have a Jack Russell, a short-legged Jack Russell called Harry. He's normally with me everywhere, and most people, I've heard him on the stream because he's either barking at something that's happening or he's generally about being a nuisance. And I've got some fish as well that like to waggle their face.
Are we likely to see Harry on your webcam in the future? That's the question for me.
Yeah, you could well do. You could get some extreme close-ups of his face and nose.
Cool. So question number 10, is this your main hobby pastime, or do you have any other interests you like to do when you're not gaming or making videos?
Well, when I'm not gaming and making videos, I've always done homebrew over the years. You know, 22 years I've brewed homebrew, so I'm a massive, I like to brew my own ale. I have a massive passion for carp fishing as well, so I've not managed to go on wet a line this year. I've been busy doing work commitments like that, but generally I'll mix it up between streaming, and then the next weekend I'll go out and be on a bank of a river or a lake somewhere looking for carp. Just getting leery on my own, bit of a radio on, it's lovely, get away from the computer, get away from everything, it's nice. And I've got a massive passion for motorcycles as well, so I do like to go and do, a friend who goes drag racing and stuff, and I go and take, I've got an exhibition bike that I like to take out to shows and put in competitions and, you know, that sort of thing.
Yeah, I think we might have a clip of you doing some extreme motorcycle riding as well in the background. Do you want to tell us about this burnout?
Yeah, but it's one of my multiple burnouts, but as you can see on this one, I managed to get one hand off the bar. And yeah, really lived the dream. It's not the biggest bike I've done the burnout on, but it was definitely one of the loudest ones with the most smoke. Good old,
awesome.
good old GPZ.
Question number 11. What has been your own favourite clip or series you have recorded?
Well, there's been so many, because all the ones that I do put onto my YouTube, you know, they've made it past what I think is good, or it's made me laugh and I've enjoyed. But I think the all-time favourite one is the actual on Arma Free Life. We managed to take a jumbo jet, take it up into the sky, stall it, and reverse land it on stream, and it was like a boss straight onto the runway, and it was by far one of the best things ever, just to catch on the stream. So yeah, that's been my favorite clip.
Yeah, also I remember watching that, but it is playing in the background as we're speaking.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah. Oh, mate.
Are you trying to do wishful?
Okay, question number 12. Tell us and our channel viewers an interesting fact about yourself.
Interesting fact about myself. I am an excellent cook. I have been a chef in a couple of food establishments. I have cooked all my life. Mum taught me and then carried on teaching myself, but I am quite a good cook, and nothing phases me, you know what I mean? If I'm just given a pan and a couple of bits of stick and a lighter and that, I can, you know, I'm aware I can make anything, even if we're out in the middle of nowhere, you know. I'm quite good at foraging and stuff like that, and yeah, I just can chuck anything together, season it, and still make a decent meal. So I've got that. That's an interesting fact about me.
The Moosies.
Yeah.
Yep, absolutely. And we're all coming around to yours for dinner this Sunday. Did we mention that?
It's grass soup this Sunday.
Grass soup. Yeah. Well, I'm there, you know. As long as it tastes all right. See, that grass stuff is quite popular, really. You know, that they make a drink out of it. I don't know what it's called, but... question number 13. If you had to choose to be one of the characters out of any game, who would it be and why?
So many, isn't there? I mean, the dude from Postal. How good it would be just to be the dude from Postal running around smacking people in the face with shovels. But I suppose you could just do that anyway in life. I think. I suppose it'd be Duke Nukem for me, because it was just awesome in every way. You know what I mean? His little comments and stuff like that, and blasty stuff, and it was. Yeah, I suppose it'd be Duke Nukem me. It was quite fly.
Okay, 14, and we're down to the last three questions now. 14, what is your views on Twitch banning 18 plus violent games such as Grand Theft Auto 5 and real graphic content?
Well, I think it's a good idea, because it's got to the point now where most people who play GTA 5 are the age of 18, and they're playing it on a console, and there's no restriction on that. You know, a parent can go and buy the kids a game and stuff, and then they just think, oh yeah, he's going to play on the console for a good few hours. But they don't realise some of the stuff he's doing, like, you know, ripping people out of cars and just stuff they shouldn't really understand and get to know about until they're a bit older. And it's to actually do it and broadcast it and try for people to make money from it and stuff like that off a stream. I think they've done the right thing myself, because It's only good, you know what I mean? They're still going to get it, they're still going to watch it, whether it's on YouTube or whether it's them playing themselves.
Oh my god, I deserve it.
It's just another way of slowing it down, I think. So I think it's a good idea. I mean, my getting to my stream, you've got to say you're over 18, right? I run a mature content stream. Now, it's only a case of somebody thinking, yeah, I'm over 18, I can come in. And, you know, I am aware of that in my head, and I do try and keep it as reasonable as possible, but you know, I put everything in place to let them know what's happening when they come into my door.
Yeah. Okay, so question 15, what advice can you give to all the new streamers who are just starting off?
Right, hi guys, and welcome. Obviously, you've got to keep at it. If people slag you off or not interested or don't watch your videos or anything like that, you've just got to keep at it. There's a game out there that will really suit you and your style, especially for your stream. Like, for example, I've started streaming Clash of Clans and it's done nothing. In the last 3 or 4 days, I've gained maybe close to 30 followers just doing Clash of Clans, and it seems to be working really well for me. I've got a bit of knowledge on the game. I do some successful war attacks, and it works quite well. And I'm starting to put out stuff on YouTube for that, what's getting views. So you've just got to find your sweet spot, and you can't be scared of going and chopping, changing games until you find something where you're going to get the viewers in. It's not necessarily about doing the game that's out at the exact moment, the popular ones, because I found that we're doing Ark. I got Ark and stuff, and I weren't getting many views and stuff or anything like that because all the other popular streamers were doing it. So when you've got that many followers, such as Lyric or anyone else, the big boys, everyone's going to tune in and watch them when it's on. So you've got to think outside the box a bit and maybe do something a little bit different out your library, and you'll get people who are interested in that coming to have a look.
Yeah, that's good advice for everybody out there who's just starting. The last question for today, what would you like to say to all your fans, followers and donators who have put you here today?
Well, it's obviously a massive thanks, you know what I mean? I'm lucky enough to say a lot of my early followers and stuff were people who actually played alongside of and who came and followed and wanted to watch me do some streaming, and they helped me out so much with getting some of my numbers up and stuff. So yeah, thanks to them. And obviously anyone who's donated, because it does go back. I do put it back in. I've just done an actual prize draw. I've got 159 followers now, but I had a goal set at 150. So from the donations I've actually received, and some donations have been people donating me CD keys, and from the money I've been donated, I bought CD keys. So I've just donated out two games back into my followers, picked them out at random with Rafa tickets, and yeah, I'm ready to go again. So when I've set another follower goal, so it's doing little things like that. It's something nice to give back to them, and especially if they're going to keep coming back and watching. And if you can retain your viewers, like I'm managing to do at the moment, cheers, thanks. I'm saying I'm doing something right. Thank you.
Cool. Okay, so we're going to end this interview now. People that see your YouTube channel or watch you streaming will know that you've got a little bit of a musical side, my missus. play one of your videos here. Do you want to let us know sort of how this comes about, or what makes you, rap and be really musical on your streams and on YouTube?
Well, I'm quite an old school guy, obviously. I revealed my age early on. But I've DJed and stuff. I've done big parties and I've MC'd with some of the good MC's back in the early 90s, 90, 91, 92, something like that. I've always had the ability to do something like that. And I think just as the evening progresses and it gets later on and you're having a good bit of banter with your mates on TeamSpeak and stuff, it's quite funny sometimes. I just get on one and it's something, somebody could just say something on TeamSpeak or something like that, and I'll just put some tunes on and away we go with it. So yeah, that's what sparks me off, and it's funny, you know what I mean? My actual follow alert is some of the stuff I've done, and when you actually follow me and you just hear everyone laughing in the background from me going £2, £1 fish, the whole TeamSpeak's erupting, man. It's just, that's why I do it, because it's good, you know, everyone enjoys it.
Fantastic. Well, thank you very much for taking the time to answer these questions today. We've got all your contact details for all your channels in the notes below. So if you want to check out my missus and BanterCrew, all the details are in the show notes below. Thank you very much for watching. And we'll end with this fantastic rap from my missus. Thank you. If you really look at yourself, you would be speechless. What happened to being doctors and teachers? What happened to being your brother's keeper? Nowadays, kids more worried about the...
You know? Wave it, yeah. Wave it, yeah. I said wave it, yeah. Wave it like a bag of cheesy quavers, yeah. Hey, here we go. You never know. Found some tunes tonight to play to you. I don't know what they're gonna do. I'm just gonna rap it out of my head. I'm gonna call myself Dread. You never know, I'm gonna go to my bed. I'm gonna have to wake up and go to work. I'm gonna have to do that fucking twerk in people's gardens, yeah. When they're not looking, I'll be fucking twerking, yeah. Pushing my lawnmower when they're not fucking knowing. Weeding out their garden beds. Wipe them off my heads. They don't know that I'm still there. I've been smoking weed in my fucking car. That's how I roll. I turn up to the gardens. They don't know. I've smoked more weed than I'll pull up out the garden. You know, I smoke more weed than I'll pull up out the gardens. Yeah. I buy it by the pounds. I don't buy it from Poundlands. I get it from a decent mate. It's a good weight. Yeah, that's how I roll. Some people say I should live under a bridge, like an internet fucking troll, because I swear a lot. I tell people what I've got. I don't care, you know, I've got a bike, a car, a fucking house. I've got a nice wife and two kids. I've got some fish in a bowl down in my kitchen. They like it in the morning. It's almost like waggle the face to go, yeah, he's gonna feed my face. Because I like to feed my fish. I give it in a dish. I feed my dog. I take him out. Take him to my house. Take him out. He catches mouse. Because he's a Jack Russell. It is no fussle. I'm talking shit now. I don't know where I'm going. Yeah. I can't believe that people listen to me whilst I rap the shit to thee. Yeah. Maybe it's because it's the good rhythm in the background. Maybe it's because I'm going to do the fat round. I get my words and my lyrics. Precisely.